Happy birthday, Yoko. Yeah, so today is Yoko's 78th, if my math is correct, birthday. She was born today, February 18th, 1933. She's actually about a year younger than my grandmother. So yeah, Yoko was born today in Tokyo. I'm gonna read a little thing. I'm gonna read a short little bio of her because personally, I don't really know much about Yoko. I mean, I know like the basics, but I don't really like know her actual details because I never read up on that. But I'm gonna read a little Yoko bio for you in case you just want some generalizations about her life up until this point. From this book right here, which is a great book, and you all should go pick it up. I got mine at Barnes & Noble. But I think you can find it at Amazon. I've seen it. Anyway, I'm gonna read. Yoko Ono was born into a prosperous Tokyo banking family on the 18th of February, 1933. Her formative years were spent commuting between Japan and America, where her father worked. At the end of World War II, the family relocated to the U.S., They settled in the well-heeled Scarsdale district of New York, and Yoko attended Harvard and Sarah Lawrence School, where Linda Eastman would also study. Actually, there's quite a lot of similarities between Yoko and Linda. Against her family's wishes, she married Japanese musician Toshi Ichiyagi, an ill-starred match that foundered long before the couple's 1962 divorce. By then, she had already met her second husband, New York musician and film producer Anthony Cox, with whom she had a daughter, Koyoko, born the 8th of August, 1963. Over the next 3 years, Yoko made a name for herself as an avant-garde artist. She published Grapefruit, a book filled with Zen-like instructions, and her conceptual artwork included a forerunner to bagism. In September 1966, Yoko and Cox came to London to further her career, which needed new sponsorship. She attended a symposium called The Destruction of Art and naturally fell into the orbit of Barry Mills, Peter Asher, and John Dunbar, who ran Indigo Gallery and were acquainted with the Beatles. John met Yoko on the 9th of November 1966 when he attended her Indigo exhibition titled Unfinished Paintings and Objects. Exhibits such as a card inviting the reader to breathe appealed to John's wry sense of humor. 18 months passed before Yoko's tenacious pursuit of John bore fruit. In that time, the self-styled high priestess of the happening featured regularly in the newspaper columns, which reported on events such as wrapping the Trafalgar Square lions with paper. Yoko regularly turned up uninvited at Kenwood, and in May 1968, when Cynthia out of the country, John yielded to her enigmatic charms. The pair made experimental tapes that would eventually be released as Two Virgins. They also became lovers. The couple collaborated on a number of projects. While Yoko's attendance at Abbey Road during Beatles recording sessions caused resentment, exacerbating existing tensions. John and Yoko married on 20th of March, 1969, inviting the world's press to their honeymoon, Bed In for Peace. They moved to New York after the Beatles disbanded, and following an 18-month estrangement, when John cohabited with personal assistant May Pang, the couple reconciled in 1975. Sean Taro Ono Lennon was born on the 9th of October that year. Over the next 5 years, Yoko showed considerable business acumen, quadrupling their fortune while John took on the role of house husband. He had just returned to the creative arena with Double Fantasy when the inevitable happened. Not the inevitable, when the tragedy happened. Since then, Yoko has released a number of John's works and many others in her own right. She has attended countless dedication ceremonies, including the inauguration of Strawberry Fields Memorial in Central Park, near the Dakota Building apartment they shared. She's also a peace activist. Doesn't really say that here. She's a peace activist. She's for gay rights. So yeah, Yoko is pretty interesting person, I feel. Even though I don't know much about her. I don't. Okay, I was gonna answer some questions, but I feel like this video is long enough. Nobody really wants to watch videos that are 8 minutes long. And I'm quite guilty of making videos that long or longer, so I'm gonna try to end this one kind of short. But next Friday is George's birthday, so I wanted to get your opinions on what we could do. I mean, I'm sure the other scruffs and myself will have a little birthday tribute video for him that day. Probably just us wishing him happy birthday. Maybe Fishy will play guitar. But if you guys would like to participate in any way, like messages or video responses, tributes, artwork, whatever you want to do for George's birthday, and you want it to be featured in our video, which would be really fantastic. We've not had that happen before. Well, I think once before. I think it was for John, like way back. But never any artwork. That'd be pretty cool. Anyway, so if you want to participate in the George birthday video, just leave a comment down below. Also, you can message us if you don't feel comfortable leaving a comment. And we'll get back to you. Alrighty then. See you next Friday. Bye.